help here!
Thank you.
feet again.
Unending darkness. Bless the Seven! I am restored!
Thank you.
I needed that.
Wulgrave spotted a trap.
Careful, I've spotted a trap.
Wulgrave spotted a trap.
Careful now, that's a trap.
Wargraf spotted a trap. Wargraf spotted a trap. Wargraf spotted a trap. Wargraf spotted a trap. Wargraf spotted a trap. Wargraf spotted a trap. Moving two fingers slowly over the palm of his other hand, Wargraf seems to signal you had better tread carefully here. There's treasure to be found, but traps as well. Wargraf seemed to have spotted something, but then signals never to mind. Wargraf spotted something.
This is fantastic! Imagine all the spectacular experiments one could get up to here.
Spectacular in the right hands, horrific in the wrong.
Greetings, greetings! One of Cassandra's, I presume? Yet rather more warm than is her preference, aren't you? Ah, a kind ruler is she. Leaves me to my experimentations and my devices here, so long as I honor her occasional requests for this and that. Nightmare potions, paralysis salves, essentials for one in her line of work. I haven't heard anything from her esteemed brother in quite some years, though. Tell me, have you word? Is that so? Well, my point about changing fashions rings true. Yet, his sister seems to be living on quite fine. Very strange, considering their forge of souls, but... My... Oh, my goodness. Could it be that he... To his own sister? No! It's much too ghastly! Heavens, a thing like that? Well, you see, it's no secret that the great Bracchus Rex and his sister, our own Cassandra, were soul-forged from a very young age. This gave them special insights into one another's psyches, and they were inseparably close. It also meant, however, that killing one would kill the other. If, say, Bracchus received an arrow through his heart in battle, Cassandra might drop dead over toast and tea halfway round the world. It is impossible to break a forge of souls completely, but it is rumored that certain steps could be taken. If one member of the forge were to be turned, for instance, into a half-living, half-dead creature, he or she would attain a form of immortality. Thus, the fully human member of the pair would be freed of the influence of his or her counterpart. It could be possible that it was Bracchus himself who granted Cassandra this certain brand of immortality. Yes, the great king was gaining power quickly. Ha! I imagine his greatest vulnerability, Cassandra, had to be dealt with. But it is a terrible fate, you see. A lich, half woman and half corpse, unable to enjoy the pleasures of life, but only to pursue death. To think that one could exact such a fate upon one's own flesh and blood. Unfathomable. Ha! The Alchemist, of course. I think I must have had a proper name once, but there hasn't been much occasion to use it for the past several decades. No, no. Alchemist suits me just fine, don't you think? Why, isn't it obvious? Beautiful alchemy! That science of the gods themselves! Yes. Before my change, I was a regular master of the alchemical arts. Tinctures for princes, wounded pride, powders to smooth skin ravaged by time. I could craft them all with ease. These days, of course, I serve only Lady Cassandra. How she discovered a method of extending life without the use of the stone of the philosopher, I cannot say. She never revealed much in the way of secrets to yours truly. Perhaps you can. Of course you may, but if you're having trouble with the whole affair, I'd suggest that perhaps it's your perception you ought to work on first.